Hi, welcome to this video on 5 reasons why pet brands should market to millennials. So I wanted to record this video today because a while ago we ran a poll with pet businesses in our Facebook community group and we're like, do you actively market to millennials? And the majority of responses were mixed, to be honest, but there didn't seem any impulse to want to deliberately market to millennials. And as a millennial pet owner myself, it just kind of rang a bell in my head and I was like, well, why not? Like, there's this amazing opportunity here, in my opinion. And the pet businesses that aren't marketing to millennials are actually missing a trick. So I thought, why not create a video that's walking through the reasons why you should be targeting millennials in any marketing that you do. And I suppose I should preface this by saying, I don't mean that you should just narrow your complete marketing down to specifically to millennials. That might work for some pet businesses, for others, it might not. But it's just something to be conscious of and not to actively exclude this demographic from your marketing. So, why should you be marketing to millennials? The first reason is they're becoming the dominant pet parents within the target market itself. And to actually expand upon this point, I wanted to look at some stats for you today because I love a stat. So, in the UK, 2.1 million millennials collected a new pet in lockdown. I think you'll agree that's a lot of millennials buying a lot of pets. So, there's like, we all know there's been a massive boom in pet ownership and adoption during lockdown itself. But the fact that so many millennials are going out and purchasing pets, this means this whole segment of your target market has suddenly opened up. And I know that this is a UK stat, so if you're in Australia or the US, this might not seem as relevant to you. But just because this is an indicator of what's happening in the UK, it's going to be happening elsewhere in the world too. So just think, all these millennials are suddenly pet parents and they're needing to purchase all these products, all these services, and it's just a huge opportunity. In Australia specifically, 70% of 18 to 24-year-olds are pet owners. Now, this is kind of crossing the boundary into Gen Z, and I suppose I should just take a step back and just, clarify that. By millennials, we're talking about, kind of 1981 to 1996 age bracket. So this is a little bit younger than that, but still. Doesn't that show that such a young population in Australia are pet owners? And they're going to make up, again, a large portion of your target market. So why wouldn't you talk to those people? The second reason is millennials are highly active online. And this kind of might just seem obvious, but it's really worth stressing. And again, there's some stats to just prove this. Overall, 65% of pet owners post about their pets on social media an average of 2 times per week. I don't know about you, being a pet owner yourself and in the pet biz industry, I'm always posting about my pet. I typically don't post about myself. I'll post about my dog Winnie or one of my cats Ollie or one of my tortoises even, but I rarely post about myself. So what does that mean in terms of millennial marketing though? Well, there's like 2.7 billion monthly active users on Facebook, and millennials make up the largest user base. So, if for example you're advertising on Facebook, your dominant audience are going to be millennials. So, why wouldn't you talk to millennials? And again, in Instagram, 1 billion monthly active users, and again, millennials make up the largest user base at 33.1%. Both platforms, when you talk about social media advertising in particular, Facebook and Instagram are the immediate ones that spring to mind, right? And both of these platforms have the largest millennial user base. It's just something to consider, right? The third reason, they look to small to medium businesses to purchase. And by this, I know that a lot of kind of businesses that I'm talking to right now will be in that bracket of small to medium. You're not going to be kind of like the Amazons of the world, are you? So, the fact that millennials are looking to actively purchase from small to medium businesses is significant. 62% of millennials say they've spent more at small businesses now than they did last year. An amazing opportunity, wouldn't you agree? And 63% of millennial consumers say they're more likely to support small businesses with digital presences. So if you're active on something like social media, you've got a website, you've got a blog, millennials are going to be drawn to that, and they want to support small businesses that show that they're active and that they're wanting to engage. They're wanting to connect on digital platforms too. Reason four, they support sustainability. This is particularly good if you are the kind of pet business who is looking to incorporate sustainable practices into your practices, your procedures, your products, your services, whatever they may be. 71% of millennials say they will pay more for a product if it has a good cause behind it. This is kind of getting into, I suppose, the realm of branding here to a degree. But what we mean by this is like, you have to develop yourself beyond just being a business who's selling a product or service. If you have that brand story behind you, if you showcase your values, if you show that you have a bigger mission, vision, and purpose beyond just that consumer aspect, they are more likely to get behind you and be loyal to you, more importantly. In a pet food survey, 28% of respondents aged 18 to 34 said they're interested in seeing more sustainably sourced pet food. This means that they're actively searching out alternatives to just the chain brands. Again, as I mentioned earlier, if you're competing against something like Amazon, particularly in the UK and USA, but like the big pet food stores in Australia too, you can position yourself in a very powerful and effective capacity by leaning into this sustainable element. There's conception around big brands and again Amazon and those chains where they don't really prioritize sustainability as much as small to medium businesses do. So if you can really tap into that messaging and if you can resonate with millennials in that capacity, then again they're going to be so much more loyal to you. And also they're going to start to spread the word about you. They're going to be telling their friends, they're going to be telling other millennial pet parents. They will become natural brand advocates for you. And reason five, leading on from my last point, is they're incredibly loyal. I know that myself as a millennial pet owner. If I find a brand that I believe in their sustainable practices, if I believe in their vision, their mission, their values, if I feel like they're actively trying to engage with me online and they're not just like posting for the sake of promoting, but they also want to kind of bring me into their community, then of course I'm going to gravitate to those brands and I'm going to choose them each and every time over, just those faceless, Felixes of the world, that just the chains that really just aren't humanized to the degree that small to medium businesses can be. So some more stats. In a survey, 50% of millennials said that they use social media to spread the word about products or services they love. And again, that kind of ties into the last point that I was making is like, if you have these sustainable practices, or if you have a really clear vision or mission, or if you, even if you're just having fun on social media, or if you have an active digital presence, we're the age group who are actively going to go out of our way to spread the word about your business. You don't have to pay us. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to invest more energy. We'll be doing that for you just off our own back, just because we've bought into your business to that degree and we believe in you and we want to see you succeed and we want more people like us, more millennial pet owners, to jump on board and to see you have that growth and that success over your competitors. 62% of millennials surveyed said that it's important to buy from companies that support their own political and social beliefs. And again, if you can kind of demonstrate this in your social media, for example, or whether it's blogs, if it's video content, if it's on your website, whatever capacity you want to do that or communicate that, if you have that strong identity in yourself as a business and are able to communicate this to millennials, then of course we're going to support that because, as I mentioned earlier, you're humanizing your business essentially. You're not just some faceless corporation who's trying to sell us pet products, pet food, pet accessories for the sake of profit. It shows that you care. You care about us, you care about our pets, you care about the world, and it's more of that collective community energy that we essentially are looking for from brands in this day and age. So to just go back over the points that I've made today, why should you be marketing to millennials? Well, number one is they're beginning to dominate your target market essentially. If not now, they're going to age into the point that they do. Point two, they're active online. If you're going to be publishing online, there's no point trying to reach a demographic that isn't already active on that platform because they're not there. They're just like full stop, they're not there, but millennials are. Again, a prime opportunity. Point three, they support small biz. They actively search out small businesses in comparison to just the convenience of big business. Point four, they're conscious consumers. As I mentioned before, if you've got that sustainability slant to your products or services, we are much more interested in that, and we will more likely be willing to pay a higher price point for that. And number five, they're loyal. If you show that you care about us, we'll show that we care about you. Simple as that. And that's something that, again, kind of small to medium pet businesses can do very well. And they can do it strategically too. So what are your next steps? Because whilst it's great kind of learning about all these stats and kind of getting an idea of what kind of activity is going on with the millennial market, you also want kind of those practical steps of, okay, so how can I start talking to this millennial market? How can I start attracting them? How can I engage them? So I've just come up with very five quick fire tips that you can just implement today, tomorrow, next week, and just really think about how you can start reaching this customer base. So the first point is mobile optimize everything. I haven't gone into the stats in this particular video, but I may in the future, but we are incredibly active on mobiles as well. So whilst we might be using Facebook and Instagram, we're, I'd say, rarely going onto desktop for that. We're more so turning to apps on mobiles, and especially your website. Mobile optimize your website. The amount of times I've gone onto a pet brand's website and it's just all over the place in terms of a mobile view. And that just puts me off. It just doesn't look professional. It doesn't look great. And it really reduces that customer experience. So of course I'm going to click away. So whatever you do, just make sure that you've mobile optimized everything that you're putting out there. Number two, customer care. It's kind of, as I said before, if you care about us, we'll care about you. So just really make sure that that customer experience with you is personalized. It doesn't have to be really time intensive. It could just be like a follow-up email, just being like, did you find everything okay? Did you enjoy the product? Did you enjoy the service? Like, we really enjoyed having you kind of as part of our community. Just make it personalized, make it feel warm and engaged and empathetic. Point three, mind your language. Fun this. I mean, use language that millennials will resonate with. And I don't mean by that just kind of start incorporating like loads of slang into your kind of your social media posts or your engagement or anything like that, but make it accessible to potentially a younger demographic. Don't be so kind of uptight and stuffy or technical with your words. Make it casual, make it fun, make it friendly. One of my top tips for anything you do, especially again on social media, but also with email and blog content, is if you would not say it in real life, if you wouldn't say it to your friend or your family member, then don't use that kind of language, because it's not natural and it comes across as inauthentic. Number four, reach out. Now, this is a bit more time intensive, and hopefully you have a team member who can do it, or maybe you can just bring a friend in who can help you in your business, or maybe you do have your own kind of marketing department within your small to medium business already. But what I mean by this is start to be active in how you're engaging that millennial market. Don't expect them to come to you, especially if you don't have the biggest social media following and you're like, I keep on posting and nobody's responding. It's because it's like, yeah, why would we? But if you reach out to us instead, if you meet us where we're at, we are much more likely to reciprocate that relationship. We feel like that you've invested that energy to just say hey to us, or, you know, comment on one of our posts, or to like, and, you know, to share some of our own stuff, that we'll be like, oh, great, they love me. They love my social media presence. So, of course, I'm going to check them out. I'm going to follow them. You know, just easy wins like that. So be active in how you're reaching out to that millennial market rather than expecting them just to naturally gravitate to you. And point five is educate them. If you're like thinking throughout this entire video is like, sorry, you just hear the cuckoo. If you're thinking at this point that the millennial market just doesn't care about my product or service, then you've got to educate them as to why they should care about your product or service. You're in the pet business game to enrich the life of pets, yes? So of course, that's what they are going to want as a millennial pet parent. And this is going to be another video that I'm going to come to in the future, but one thing that you may be particularly battling at the moment is that instant gratification fix that the big business like Amazon can facilitate, you know, the next day delivery. So if that's something that you're finding is a bit of an obstacle to engaging a younger demographic to purchase from you, what you need to do is educate them on why it's better to slow things down, to not have that instant gratification fix, because the quality of your customer service, the quality of your product is so much better and superior to the chains that can deliver things the next day. It's all about just reframing the psychology of their experience with you. And like I said, educating them as to the benefits of your product or service if they don't understand that already. So I hope this video has helped. If you have any questions at all, just make sure to drop us a comment or send us an email. We're on all the social media platforms. But I just want you to take from this video, how can you start engaging this target market if you aren't already, and just be a bit more active with it. Just rather than just doing this kind of scattergun blanket, I'm just going to market to every pet parent. Think about how you can be strategic and how you connect with and engage with that millennial market. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll speak to you soon.